Hi there, my name's James. If you got the time, I got the games. We're downstairs on the ship, and we're about to talk to Ben King, so let's go ahead and activate this.
I'm working on an epic sci-fi follow-up to Regicide. I'm in the research phase, but the damn Zen blew up the internet. I need you to do some legwork for me.
Legwork, huh? All
right. Right, the last couple videos we did both of the story DLC packs for this game. We did Enter the Dominatrix and How the Saints Saved Christmas, but before we did that, we saved Ben King from the simulation and did his loyalty mission. So we're ready to go in and do all of his side quests. His are a lot of street fighting. He was the leader of the Vice Kings after all, so there's a lot of virus injections and a lot of flashpoints. Just a lot of fighting. And I did want to use the disintegrator as much as possible, because I want to beat that challenge.
I want to see you take down one of those Zen hotspots.
I built, I watched, and then I acted. That's how I brought the Vice Kings up to be one of the strongest crews in Stillwater. Only problem was my lieutenants didn't have the same patience. That bitch Tanya drove a wedge between Tony and Warren. Then she convinced Warren to try and take me out, only to stab him in the back and take it all for herself. I may have lost the Vice Kings, but killing her almost made it worth the trouble. Good thing the player was there to help. After the fall of the Vice Kings, I figured it was time to get out of the game. Living the life I had, I didn't want all that experience to go to waste. Figured a book would allow me to work out my demons and show the world what the game took from me. Didn't know it'd take off so well. Shit, if I had known back then what I do now, probably would have gone legit sooner.
All right, let's bust out the Zinyak statue on the way there. Obviously, we've got a hotspot that he wants us to do first, but since we just pulled him out of the simulation and into the real world, all of his audio logs are right around this first hotspot. As a matter of fact, so are Tanya's. Since we beat his loyalty mission, we've gotten Tanya's audio logs. We'll grab hers too.
Putting me in charge of the brothels was the best idea King ever had. There's no way anyone else in Stillwater would have been able to control the girls the way I did. It brought in the money, it brought in the clients, and it would have been the backbone of the Vice Kings if Gat and all the Saints hadn't ruined it all.
I always knew the Saints were ambitious, but I never thought I'd see them end up in the White House. And when the player called me saying how they couldn't do it without me, how could I say no? Thought maybe I was in line for vice president, but I guess Keith beat me to it. Still,
is anyone counting these kills?
Perks. Not bad for a kid from Sunnyvale Gardens.
Yeah, let's get in some of our telekinesis throws. That's another challenge that we've got to beat. There, we only need 20 more to beat that challenge. I do want to do that in this video, try to complete as many challenges as we can. Not just with the disintegrator.
At 66%.
The only weapons that we've beaten the challenge with so far are the tentacle bat. And it took us both Enter the Dominatrix and How the Saints Saved Christmas to beat that challenge with the bounce rifle. But we only need 100 kills with the disintegrator, and I'm hoping to have that done by the end of this video. That may or may not happen, we'll see. This is a pretty big hotspot. Alright, make some room. And we'll start trying. The hardest part about beating the challenge with the disintegrator is that it doesn't fire right away. It has to charge before it fires. So you're taking a lot of damage while you're... There's just Zen all around you, blasting you while you're waiting for this thing to charge to shoot each one of them. Oh, look out! Yeah, he had an RPG.
Don't worry, everyone loses to me.
Okay, we just completed that challenge. All our free shatters. And when you use the freeze blast and then hit somebody with the disintegrator, it doesn't count as a disintegration. It counts as a freeze shatter. But that one's in. Yeah, these over here, they jump around so much. You gotta get them to stand still or you can't get them with this weapon.
Activating main defenses.
Very nice. All that's left is the actual hotspot, but we're not done with enemies.
Reinforcements engaged.
Get rid of him. And the disintegrator obviously does blow up portals too, so that's all good. get rid of the shield first. And where did that guy go? There he is. Two shooting at us. Oh yeah, they've got a really good vantage point. We're not going to get it with these two here. Yeah, get him out of here. And looking at the map, we might be in the clear. We might be able to get this right now. Yeah, we're good. We got it. Awesome. All right, very cool. Man, most of Ben King's side quests, like I said, are just like that. It's just a lot of fighting, a lot of guys shooting at you.
I see the main character is a tough guy. I want to see how you handle a Zen patrol.
Right, got another flashpoint. This one's way up high on a building. So yeah, let's hit him with some mind control first. Give us some time. Whoa, that was way too high. That's not what I was trying to do. I know there's always two Zen up here. This is what I was trying to do. That one. Yeah, get out of here.
Just better than everyone.
Yeah. We got both of them in one shot. Yeah, this one comes with a warden. When the disintegrator's upgraded, you can shoot through targets and shoot the target behind them too, so that's pretty cool. Well, yeah, let's get this warden off of here. With all these dead Zen flying. We don't want to be trapped in close quarters with this warden. Alright, come on, yeah. Stop him. Okay, here we go. I said it before, you really gotta button mash like crazy here, especially at this point in the game. Oh, get it, get it. Ugh.
Shouldn't have shown up.
Man. Yeah, we're pretty deep into the game right now. Because we've already done all the side quests for five of our homies, and there's only three left. So those wardens are pretty hard to take down at this stage. But we'll go ahead and take Santa's sleigh, which we've unlocked.
What does it feel like when you hack one of those Zen stores? Show me.
Yeah, the best part about doing those story DLCs, which is why I did them in the first place, is I wanted all of the VTOLs that come with them. Because we've still got a lot of flying all over the map to do. It's not so bad with Ben King, but when we get to Asha and Johnny, we're going to be flying around all over the place. Especially Johnny. And we did unlock some weapons with that, but really the only one I'll probably use will be the Crimson Cowboy from the Christmas DLC. Once that slot in our weapon wheel's opened up. Alright, hold on, got a rib job down here. Didn't land anywhere near it, but we're okay. Right, obviously a store hack. This is the last store hack in the game. Interesting thing about this is that after we're done, this isn't a challenge to complete, and there's 34 of these, and a lot of these are really hard to, really time-consuming to figure out. You think this would count as one of the challenges, but it doesn't. Which surprises me, because everything else in the game that you have to do is its own challenge. But that's it for those. No more hacking for the rest of the walkthrough.
What's involved in injecting a virus into the simulation exactly? I want to know.
Yep, clearly another virus injection coming up. More fighting, more street fighting. But there's a couple things we can pick up on the way. Like, next to this bridge, there's a pier, there's a Zenyak statue down here, which we can get from the air.
Someday that'll be the real one.
We're almost done with those, too. We should be done with those when we do Asha's side quest. But the last two audio logs for Tanya are right around this virus injection, so we'll go ahead and grab these. Get them out of the way.
King never had the control he thought he did over the Vice Kings. It was all me and Warren keeping things running. Well, mostly me. Warren's ego got just as big as Benjamin's in the end. He thought the two of us would rule the city. Guess he didn't know me like he thought he did. Warren, Tony, Alderman Hughes, I had them all wrapped around my finger. They would have died for me. Come to think of it, I guess they did.
Yeah, I don't know who the actress is they got to play Tanya, but she's got this really snotty, kind of irritating voice, which I think is great for that character. But anyway, let's get into this. I also want to try to get in a lot of kills with the inflator ray. The inflator ray only needs 50. You only need 50 kills with this weapon. But since we just used the buff power, just unlocked the buff power, we'll be using that too. It's its own challenge, and it's probably the easiest challenge in the game. Because you only need 10 kills with it, or 10 ignitions. And doing virus injections, everybody just runs right up to you, so all you have to do is just turn it on, basically. Yeah, the inflator ray is a cool weapon, but you can see, in order to get kills with it, it takes a while too. And people will be shooting at you while you're trying to use this weapon. But we did the first set of side quests for Pierce, that's what gave us this weapon, but it's fully upgraded. Oh shit, Ginky! Okay, yeah, I wasn't expecting Ginky. Yeah, that throws a crimp in the plan, hold on. Ah! Yeah, we'll get him with a float stomp. Let's go with the gravity. And it didn't work, he went right through it. Sometimes the gravity floats don't work, I've said it before in other videos. Alright, yeah. But like I was saying, when you do the third set of side quests for Pierce, it completely upgrades this inflator ray, so everything explodes. Yeah. And wait, whoa, we got a guy trying to run off. Don't think so. Very cool, looks like we only need two more kills. Yeah, get out of the way. Yeah, like all the other weapons, it doesn't work when somebody's on a motorcycle. Yeah, there we go. Just wiped them all out. And this is right next to one of our gateways that ends Ben King's first set of side quests.
Fantastic. Come see me when you're ready for more.
Okay, very nice. Still got a lot of work left to do, though. The Ben King can be in either any of two places on the ship, and I like it better when he's upstairs so we don't have to run all the way down past Matt Miller. Yeah, he's upstairs. In what I guess is their bathroom.
This stuff is great, player. What I need now is to punch up the second act. Show me some good stuff.
You realize your potential readers total about 10 people, right?
Yeah, kind of like my potential viewers. But anyway, that gives us the freeze element for the buff power. Which again, I think is weird, is not its own challenge. You saw the fire ignitions was its own challenge. Okay, rising action. We go in and do Act 2 of Ben King's book. And way down over here, we could pick any of two different gateways, it doesn't really matter. But a lot more fighting.
Can you show me that virus upload thing you do again? That's good stuff.
Yet another virus injection, and this one's pretty intense. You can see it's three waves, but we want to beat this challenge with the disintegrator. We're going to take damage here. There's no way we're not going to take damage.
That guy skipped
like a lot
train?
Of damage. And these Zor ships, yeah, these are hard to get kills with the inflator ray. It's not impossible, but they move around so much, and you have to get a headshot in order to take those ships down. Nope, hold on. Got him. Yeah, we're being shot at from every side. Ah, mostly from the air, these Zor ships. Get rid of them. Our telekinesis is fully upgraded too, so that's how I like to get rid of these things. guess we could just use Freeze Blast or Fire Blast. Whoa! Didn't see the telephone pole. Alright, come on, make it happen. This is only wave two. So look how many of them there are, and they've got us point blank. Yeah, we're eating some serious damage. Yes, yeah, I saw you back here. Ah, where'd this short bus come from? This is a dead-end street. Where's this short bus going? Nice. Big flatbed truck coming down here, too. Yeah, we'll try some mind control just to get some of them not shooting at us. Whoa! Where'd this guy come from? There's no portal behind us. Okay, that's 60 of the 100. Come on, get him. We need six more guys.
I hope Kinsey's recording this.
Come on, take a step back. We only need one more kill. Very nice, yeah, and get that health back. You can see there's a flashpoint right over to the left. I'm gonna go ahead and grab a VTOL, even though where we're going next isn't really that far away, but when we're done with that, we actually have to come right back to this street. Finn King's side quests are just set up that way. You are.
I want to see you wipe this sucker out.
Alright, another rogue program, Zenimida. Yeah, this is like a Minecraft guy. Which is one of the many skins you can pick in this game. I haven't used it yet. Hold on. Yes, he comes with decoys. There's like three of them up here. So this is the one. Yeah, see, he's a Minecraft guy. Yeah, that one was a decoy. So, what about this one over here? Get him to hold still. He's being shot at, probably by police. Yeah, this is him. Alright, all good. And it looks like our sleigh disappeared. But that's alright, like I said, we're just going right back to the same street. That street is like a dead end on both sides. Yeah, this is right where we just came from. You can see it's a dead end on this side, too. Another flashpoint, obviously. And I probably shouldn't use Freeze Blast, because those don't count as disintegrations. Still all good, come on. Right. Oh, he was the last one. Well, I saw two more red blips on the map. There was a portal there, too. Another virus injection.
I lost my notes on that virus injection thing, player. Can you do
I'm still standing!
Okay, yeah, so we've done a virus injection that was all Zen, we've done one that was a biker gang, and this one's all police. Oh, man! Did that get all of them? That got all of them. That was 10 kills. Yeah, I don't think we were supposed to kill them all that quickly. But the reason why I like to use the buff power most of all is not only does it keep surrounding attackers off you, but you walk faster. We've upgraded it so you move quicker. And yeah, let's get on one side of them so we're not being surrounded. Ah, yeah, it didn't blow up the car there. Took out three of them, though. Right, yeah, I saw you shooting at me. Okay, that was wave one.
shouldn't have fucked
with the president. Yeah, gotta lose these cars. This is a great weapon. Thirty or 50 of these. Yeah, it doesn't take long to beat this challenge. But if you watch the last couple videos, you see how long it takes to beat the bounce rifle challenge, and, the dubstep gun, That's what I was trying to think of. The dubstep gun, you need 250 kills with two. That one takes a while. Whoa, man! Come on, we only need two more. There we go. Alright. So that ends Ben King's second set of side quests. Oh, man. But again, it has been all street fighting.
This is fantastic, player. See me when you're ready to bring this home.
What has this all been? Flashpoints, virus injections, we did one store hack, and a rogue program. Okay, so let's hope he's upstairs again. Which, yeah, I can tell by the marker.
If this is going to be authentic, I need to make sure to get every last detail right.
Big finish, huh? Let's do it.
Yay, the Ben King suit. That's a pretty cool skin, too. If you like Ben King from the previous games, he's got a pretty cool look. He still keeps those cool yellow shoes, even though he's on the ship. He's pretty stylish. Okay. So, right over by Magarak Island is where that's another virus injection. So yeah, let's get right into it.
I know you've done this virus injection before, but it's really good character development.
And I wasn't really keeping track while we were getting shot at. But I don't know how many kills we've gotten with the disintegrator already.
Shouldn't have fucked with the president!
This is the last set of side quests, and I do want to beat that 80. Okay, cool, we only need 20 more. Then we can move on to another weapon. And the inflator ray won't take very long. There's one weapon, hold on, I see somebody coming through this alley. Yeah, another Zen card. There's a weapon that we have to, complete a challenge with that we don't even have yet. You don't unlock it until you save Johnny, and that's another one that takes a long time to beat the challenge, the Singularity Gun. Black Hole Gun, watch out for the biker! Didn't we just kill that biker, like, 10 minutes ago? Yeah, this is three waves. They don't appear to be swarming us like they were before. Car. Could have swore I saw a blip down here on the map. Don't know what happened to it, but that's alright. Yeah, got him, yeah.
Just better than everyone.
Man, no, didn't see that car. It's like a couple Zen jumped out of it before we ran it off the road. Lose it. You're not hiding from me. With any of these weapons, the kills have to be on your attackers, like those bikers, or the police, or the Zen. If you just shoot random people on the street, it doesn't count towards the challenge. And there we go! There we go, we're done. We're done with that weapon. So I guess we'll keep using the inflator ray and try to beat that one. Oh, and complete 36 other challenges! Awesome!
Okay, the enemy has the main character surrounded. Show me what he'd do against a bunch of Zen.
Then you blow him up is what you do. Look how their eyes bug out, but that doesn't happen to the Zen. We did it to the police and all their eyes popped before they exploded. Alright, very cool. Now, the next activity we're gonna do for him, hold on, let's get a little ways. It's actually the next intersection over, but we have to use Rock Stomp. Let's do it. And I'm waiting for Ben to talk. Oh, well, there he was in the subtitles, but he didn't say anything. Anyway, Stomp Mayhem. This is the second Stomp Mayhem that we've done. And this one's a lot easier than the other one. The first one takes place up in the airport, and there's very little stuff to destroy up there, so this one, I think, is a lot easier, because we're right in the middle of downtown, and every street has just got things to destroy all over the place. So what I try to do is just zigzag my way up the rogue, just keep stomping, keep the combo meter really high. I don't think these are very hard, or this one isn't anyway.
Is anyone counting these kills?
The last time we did one of these, I said that there is a trick to do. You can use the Sprint Tornado, not even stomp one time, and just run around downtown, and the Sprint Tornado will destroy everything for you, but I don't like to do it that way. It's a Stomp Mayhem, so I want to beat it with the stomp.
I think I broke your shit, Zinyak.
Man, look how high our combo is. Like I said, you just zigzag your way up the road. This isn't that tough. But it's nice to be doing something other than flashpoints and virus injections. They went as far as mayhems go. When we get to Johnny's side quest, there are a lot of mayhems in that one. Johnny likes to blow shit up, so Johnny just wants to destroy everything. Damn, there's our gold. Look at that combo. Yeah, that was really good. So we should be done with those. That's, we got both the silver medals and the gold medals in both of those. So pretty happy about that, and we've only got one more thing to do. And we're done with Benjamin King.
I gotta get my radio fixed.
And we are gonna want to use a VTOL for this one. It's a little ways off. We're going in the direction of the airport, but we don't have to fly all the way to the airport.
Sure thing.
Yeah, we haven't used the F-69 yet. We got this from Enter the Dominatrix. This one's cool looking. I like this VTOL because look at the wingspan. As compared to the UFOs you get, but we're gonna do something different. This is the last of the Superpower Flight Clubs. Again, a lot more fighting, but this is the hardest of the three. So yeah, alright, let's psych myself up for this one.
Welcome once again to Super Power Fight Club!
Yeah, the premise again is we've got people shooting at us, using weapons. We don't have any weapons. All we've got are our superpowers, so
I am awesome!
We start out with snipers on us, so we don't want to stand still for too long. But we have to beat this with 4 minutes remaining on the clock in order to get the gold. And oh, he didn't freeze. It's like a split second too late. Watch out! That guy right in the center of the room, okay.
Wave one, complete!
Alright, not too bad. As far as time goes.
Wave two, fight!
It's like waves of Morningstar here. Oh man, yeah, and they've got RPGs. Yeah, it's like all the male attackers are Morningstar. And the female attackers look like Ronin, even though they don't have the swords. I'm gonna get these shatters in. Right under 6 minutes.
So close.
Yeah, we're being shot at from over here. I've got the alien RPGs. Like, there's a lot of different ways that you can do this, but since we're going for time, and a lot of the... all the attackers in this are really hard. Like, we started with snipers, and all these guys have superpowers. The next one, we've got the Ginky Girls.
It's King of the Hill.
So I like to alternate between Freeze Blast and... oh, man! What hit us? Between the Freeze Blast and the Freeze Element for the buff power. This King of the Hill, these are all Ginky Girls, and they all use their telekinesis, so I like to use the telekinesis to get rid of them. And we'll hit you with, what are, I guess, these giant soccer balls or whatever they are. Oh, yeah. Just like that. Yeah, I think we got this. Alright, we've got 1 minute left. And this is actually the hardest part, is catching Julius.
Julius Little!
He's constantly on the move and everybody's shooting at us with RPGs. Yeah, just like that. Come on, which way did he go? He doesn't sit still for very long at all.
Whoa!
Oh, man. Stop. Yeah, just because he's shrunk doesn't mean that he can't still use telekinesis and stomp. The shrink works good on him, though, because it's easier to kill him if you can catch him.
The opponents are on fire!
Ugh.
Literally!
Oh, okay. It looks like he got hit with an RPG explosion, and because he was shrunk, that's what killed him. But yeah, we had 425 left. And we're done with all the fight clubs. Which I'm pretty happy about, because I think all three of those are hard. That one in particular. And we may actually get 50 for XP here after we go back and talk to Ben. You have to talk to him to complete the side quest. That'll give us more XP. So we got all the silver medals and gold medals in Fight Club. Because that's two more challenges now. We beat a lot of challenges in this video. Did a lot of work, and I'm waiting for him to talk again, and... I guess not. Some kind of glitch. He didn't talk before the mayhem. He didn't talk... He's supposed to tell us to come back and talk to him again, like he did the other two times. And he is upstairs again. Alright, great. So back into the bathroom.
This is gonna be epic, player. Thanks for your help. I'll be sure to put you in a special thanks.
Gee, Ben. Thanks.
Alright, and the lightning for the buff power. See how much XP they gave us. Oh, right under 50. We're like a pixel away from 50. Alright, well, let's go in and do this, since we're here.
Can I help you?
No. Well, yes, it's... Sorry, this is a little awkward.
It's okay. Say what's on your mind.
I don't know if I can.
You never know if you can have something, unless you ask for it.
I don't want things to change between us.
Things won't change. We're professionals.
You'll see me differently.
Just shut up and say it.
Can you sign my copy of your book?
Sure. I'm
guessing that was his first book, because he's... This was the sequel to Regicide that he's writing right now. Alright. Again, we got a lot done in this video, so let's get our money. Very nice. And into upgrades. So for bonuses, discount on weapons. We got that for beating 36 other challenges. Cool. Alright. And we get the Ginky Girls. Four homies, and that's for getting the silver medals in all three of the fight clubs. And then it's in buff, passive aggressive, or the buff element is for getting the gold in all of the fight clubs. And obviously we got the freeze and the lightning just by beating the side quest. So there's really only one thing that we can do. We've done everything else. So the next video, we're gonna go save Asha. And probably throw in her loyalty mission at the end of that, too. So, I'm going to end this here. My name is James. If you got the time, I got the games. Thank you guys so much for watching.